Mikrofon. Ja, bitte schön, Kollege, in der Mitte.
Yes, please.
Hallo, Herr Kovac.
Hallo. Hello, Mr. Kovac. Joshua Kimmich said after the Paderborn game that your team hasn't managed to dominate for a whole 90 minutes. On the one hand, he's right. And if he is right, what could be done to change this?
Ja, das ist ja nicht nur jetzt eine Aussage vom Jos gewesen nach dem Paderborn-Spiel.
This wasn't only something that Joshua said after the game, it's also something I said in a press conference.
Versuchen müssen und auch schaffen müssen,
that we have to try and we have to ensure
den Gegner zu dominieren,
that we dominate the opponent for more than 60 minutes. Up to date, we've always managed to do so for 60 minutes, but we also want to try to do so for the next 30 minutes. This is never going to work unless you play against lower quality games, because of course a game always goes up and down.
Der Punkt zur ersten Frage, zur zweiten Frage.
That was it with regards to the first question. Now with regards to the second question, Joshua always gives it his all. He wants to win every game. He wants to improve in every training session. That's his aim. That's what he demands of himself, and that's what he demands from the team. And when you lead the way with a good performance, it's fair to say this. And if not, well, you yourself know how it works. Stefan Kuhnberger. Mr. Kovac, everyone's speaking of the duel of the top strikers. Now we also have two top goalies on the field. What role are they going to play? And in your opinion, who's currently in a better form?
Ja, die Torhüter sind sehr, sehr wichtig, denn
both of them are extremely important. You know how it is in a game. When you play for Bayern Munich or Tottenham, you don't always have all that much to do. And when you do have something to do, you have to perform. You have to ensure that you do not concede a goal. This is something both goalkeepers are doing extremely well at the moment. Manuel Neuer does this very well. He's a great backbone to have, not only last season, but also this season. And tomorrow, in the stadium, with this atmosphere, both goalkeepers are going to have a great day to ensure that the teams leave the pitch successfully.
Yeah, okay.
Yes, please, go ahead. Mr. Kovac, you always appear to be very cool. Now, a game against Tottenham, do you feel it in your stomach?
Das, was jeder Trainer oder auch jede Mannschaft, jeder Club möchte in der
Champions League
auflaufen.
Das ist das, is what every manager wants to do, be successful in the Champions League. Tomorrow is going to be a top game, two top teams will be meeting in a great stadium. I'm convinced that the atmosphere is going to be amazing tomorrow. We have 3 points, we want to ensure that we collect more points tomorrow. We know that the pressure is also more somewhat on the side of Tottenham, and that is why we're all going to enjoy the game tomorrow. This is what I will tell my players too, that they should enjoy the game, and when you enjoy, usually everything runs smoothly.
Yes, second row.
Hi. Could you tell us your opinion of Harry Kane as a striker in the English game, and also how do you deal with a striker like Kane defensively?
I will answer in German, okay? Ich werde es auf Deutsch machen.
I will answer in German.
Es ist wie immer. Jetzt darf ich auch etwas zu Harry Kane sagen, aber es ist unnötig, denn
now I can too say something about Harry Kane, but there's no need to do so, because I'm sure I have a lot of people standing or sitting in front of me that have already said a lot about him. Every word is too much, because his quality in the Premier League, but also in the English squad, speaks for itself. He's sensational. He's a player that can do it all. He's great at keeping the ball, he's good with his head. There's nothing he can't do. He's a very strong striker. Him and Lewandowski, I'm going to say, are probably the top two, top three, top four of the world. That's the way it is at the moment. Both of them are hugely successful. And I look forward to seeing how things will pan out tomorrow. Apart from that, I will of course give my team a bit of information about Harry Kane, which I'm not going to tell you, which you'll hopefully understand.
Servus, Herr Kovac.
Servus.
Hi, Mr. Kovac. There were debates about Thiago too today. On Saturday, you took him out after 5 years. Does he have a fixed position for you? Or could Thiago too one day be sitting on the bench?
Thiago jetzt am Samstag mit Sicherheit nicht seinen besten Tag hatte.
Thiago didn't have his best day on Saturday. I think many people saw this. He saw this too. He's a highly self-critical player who always wants to give it his all.
Wie es bei ihm ist, so ist es bei allen anderen auch, oder wie es bei anderen ist, so ist es bei ihm auch.
And it's the same for everyone.
Muss die Leistung stimmen.
At the end of the day, the performance has to be right, and when it is, you also have the justification to continue playing. Should you ever have a bad game, which of course happens, it doesn't mean that you're doomed and blocked away, but the others are waiting, the others are ready. So we'll have to see what is going to happen tomorrow in a few days.
Ja, hallo Herr Kovac. Lucas Hernandez war ein
Lucas Hernandez. Could you give us an update as to his health?
Ja, Lucas wird das Training heute nicht mit.
Lucas is not going to partake in today's training. He's going to have indoor training. He's not going to be in the stadium.
Kurz vor der Halbzeit verletzt.
He injured himself briefly before halftime. That's why we took him out in Paderborn.
Was uns dieser eine Tag noch bringt.
So we want to wait and see what this additional day
David war schon im Kader.
Will hold out for him.
David war jetzt auch in Paderborn geplant, dass er reinkommt.
Well, it wasn't planned for him to be there in Paderborn, but he's part of the team and Ivan too traveled along. He's healthy. And Ivan will also be able to compete, should he need to tomorrow. First row.
Hi Nico, can you give us an idea of how the perception of Tottenham has changed in Germany over the last few years? Obviously, they've gone from a club that were normally in the UEFA Cup to a club that were in the Champions League final last year. So could you talk about how your view of them has changed? And do you see them as equals tomorrow?
Ja, es ist eine sehr, sehr positive Entwicklung.
Very, very positive development. I think it was 3 years ago, it was 2016, I was here in February, it was still in the old stadium, I was here to watch Tottenham against Swansea.
Ja, es ist anderes Flair gewesen, kleineres Stadion.
The flair was different, the stadium was smaller, but the atmosphere was nevertheless great.
Was es heißt, wenn man eine gute Führung
hat. And you could see what it means when
einen guten Trainer hat.
You have a good leadership, when you have a good coach, good manager.
Hier letzten Endes auch nach England zu holen oder auch gerade.
When you have the good idea of bringing good players to England and especially to Tottenham.
Also für mich persönlich, aber wahrscheinlich auch für die deutschen Kollegen.
And in my opinion, and I think my German colleagues would agree, Tottenham is a very positive light in European football.
Mit den ganz, ganz großen, ja, jetzt mithalten kann, obwohl es in den
you're now able to compete with the very big teams, even though it might have not looked this way 6 or 7 or 8 years ago. But you now have continuity. The manager was given the opportunity to build something up here. He was given the time and he's done a great job.
Fingerzeig für viele andere, dass man
and I think this is a good example for others, that sometimes patience is important. And that is why it is definitely going to be a game with two teams on equal footing. Because when you look at the players on both teams, they're all world class from different countries and national teams. So we know what to expect tomorrow.
Eddie Enders and Frank Linkisch, and then we go upstairs.
Ja, hallo Herr Kovac. Serge Gnabry saß vorhin hier.
Serge Gnabry was here beforehand.
Drei, denke ich, fast gleichwertige Flügelspieler.
You have three very good wingers. Serge, Perisic, Kingsley Coman. How do you decide who gets to play? What criteria play a role? And do you consider all three of them to be equally strong? First of all, I'm very pleased that you have mentioned that all three of them are very strong.
gleichzusetzen ist mit dem, was ich am Anfang der Saison gesagt
habe. And this is also what I said at the beginning of the season when Ivan joined us. We know the discussions that were held back in the days. And in the shortest amount of time, he showed that he can play at the same level as the other two.
King hat diese Saison bisher sehr viele Tore geschossen.
King has made a lot of goals and has also provided a lot of assists this season. So here too, the development has been very positive. And in his last game against Paderborn, Serge really expressed his strength. His offensive strength. I of course expect wingers to also work towards the back. This is something we can still improve. And this is definitely something we're working on. Niko Kovac, you just alluded to it. A few years ago, you watched a game in the old stadium, now you're in this stadium. What type of play do you expect from Tottenham? How do you expect Tottenham to play tomorrow? In my opinion, it is going to be a mix. They're going to be playing in their own stadium on the island, so they're going to be pushed by the fans. Of course, you also have Bayern Munich on the other side, so they're definitely going to give it their all from the very first minute. They're going to try to put us under pressure, which this is something a lot of British teams do when they play at home.
Gibt's auch die fußballerische Komponente, die hier sehr, sehr hoch anzusiedeln ist. Also der Fußball, den
Tottenham spielt, ist the football that Tottenham plays is very beautiful to watch. It's extremely creative and innovative. And this too will be something we're going to have to handle tomorrow. So we have to ensure that we have the physical and mental resilience and that we can also respond to the challenges ahead of us.
To my question, the first part is, do Tottenham need to win silverware to be considered a top team in Europe? The second part, I want to take you back to 2007. Are you a bit disappointed that Tottenham got their stadium ready before you could return and manage Bayern Munich from the dugout at Wembley?
2007 kann ich mich ganz gut dran erinnern.
2007, I can remember it.
Jetzt muss ich noch mal die erste Frage. Jetzt habe ich, ich habe bis zu.
Now I forgot the first question. I'll first answer the second question and then move on to the first. If you could repeat it. First of all, it's nice to be back in London. In 2007, we had a great experience in the Wembley with well, our national team. This was an important victory for Croatia, 3-2 against a top opponent. Now we're here. We're not in the Wembley Stadium. We're in the new stadium here. We all look forward to it, including the players.
Could you repeat the first question again, please?
I forgot it.
And could you talk to me about the emotion of coming back to London with that match in mind? And also, okay. And also, do Tottenham need to win silverware to be considered a big team?
Oh, yeah. Ich habe 2007 hier gewonnen, genau.
We won here in 2007, and then 2 years later we played here too. But then I was no longer part of the team, so we lost 5-1. So I have a very good memory of London, which is also going to continue.
Dieses gute Gefühl, was ich damals hatte.
And I do hope that we are going to have an equally good feeling tomorrow.
Der Druck ist da. Tottenham muss
punkten. Pressure is on. Tottenham has to collect points tomorrow. We know this. We also want to take home minimum 1 point tomorrow. This will give us a good starting position for the next two games.
Hi, Coach. One question about Kingsley Coman, who is in a really good shape right now. How important is he for the team?
Ja, ich hatte das gerade eben kurz gesagt.
I just alluded to it ever so briefly. Last year, in his first Bundesliga game against Hoffenheim, Kingsley got injured. And then in the second half of the season, I also stressed how important he is for the team. This was clear once he joined us again. He's healthy now. He's on a top level, physically speaking. He's rarely been in such good form. He's also extremely well prepared mentally. He processed the injury he had very well.
Schluss dann letzten Endes war und dass er dort
him being in the national team was also the right decision. He's now shot two goals in two teams for the national team. This doesn't mean that King This means that King is good at assisting, but also good at actually scoring. And we need him, because we don't only want to rely on Lewandowski.
Here. One question about Felipe Coutinho. Since he arrived, what changed in your team in terms of way that you play?
Yeah. Felipe ist eben Felipe.
Felipe is Felipe. He's a world-class player.
Weltklasse Junge.
And a world-class lad.
He
doesn't behave like a star. He's integrated extremely well.
Sehr glücklich ist.
He's very, very happy.
Er kann nicht nur alles mit dem Ball. Das wissen wir.
He can do it all with the ball. We know that.
Auch imponiert.
What impresses me
ist die Tatsache, dass er auch gegen den Ball sehr gut arbeitet.
It's the fact that he also works extremely well against the ball. This is something that pleases me. Because we all know what he can do once he has the ball.
Macht er sehr gut, ich weiß nicht.
But also when working against the ball, he's extremely successful. I'm not sure if you all follow this, whether you observe this. You probably only pay attention to him once he has the ball. But also when we do not have the ball, he does a great job. And that's also what I expect. I apologize, I'm a little ill, says a speaker. That would also be it. Thank you very much, Nico.
Training starts in 5 minutes. You are invited to watch the first 15 minutes.
Danke.
Okay, bye-bye.